React Native had the lead until now, but in 2025, Flutter is closing the gap. So, as a software engineer, which one is beneficial to learn in 2025? Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I will break down the real differences between Flutter and React Native in terms of different fields: performance, learning curve, developer experience, and job market. Before we continue, I want you to know that this channel is all about growing as software engineers together. If you want to join it, subscribe now. Flutter and React Native are two leading tools for cross-platform development. They both have their own advantages and disadvantages. Flutter is an open-source user interface development kit released by Google in 2018. Flutter lets you build cross-platform applications for a number of platforms and operating systems. On the other hand, React Native is a mobile development framework developed by Facebook, or also known as Meta. It was released in 2015. It is possible to develop mobile, web, and desktop applications with React Native. Let's continue with the performance. When comparing these two frameworks, it's important to know about their underlying architectures. Flutter uses Dart programming language and compiles directly to native machine code. This means that it doesn't need a bridge to communicate with native components. Instead, it uses its own engine, which is Kia, to draw each pixel on the screen. This architecture gives Flutter great control over the UI. This architecture also has other benefits. It offers near-native performance, smooth animations, and faster startup times. On the other hand, React Native uses JavaScript and bridges to communicate with native UI components. When you write React Native code, it's interpreted by a JavaScript runtime, then the JavaScript runtime sends the instructions over the bridge to the native modules to render UI elements and access native functionalities. This architecture gives React Native some advantages and disadvantages. Since it's based on JavaScript, it has a large community. However, since the bridge is needed for the communication, there might be performance issues, especially for the complex animations. Another disadvantage of React Native is that debugging is a little bit harder because of the performance issues. Learning curve is also crucial for a software engineer before choosing a new technology, because the faster you learn, the faster you develop applications. When you consider the fact that JavaScript is not the most exciting programming language, it's safe to say that Flutter is easier to learn than React Native. Flutter is much more developer-friendly than React Native because it uses Dart as the programming language, which is easier to learn and understand than JavaScript. Dart is also closer to programming languages used in native mobile application development. The 2024 Stack Overflow survey also reveals that. Let's talk about what it's like to actually build apps with these frameworks, because it's also important to have a convenient experience while working. As discussed earlier in the video, React Native uses JavaScript as a programming language. If you already know about JavaScript and React for web development, the transition is smooth because they are similar. For the ecosystem, you have access to thousands of packages and libraries via NPM. React Native supports hot reload and fast refresh. These help you see changes without a full restart. However, it might be buggy when you implement complex UI due to JavaScript bridge overhead. Overall, if you're coming from a web development background, especially with React, React Native feels like home, but of course you will need to learn some other stuff on the go. When it comes to Flutter, it uses Dart programming language. This language is clean, readable, and very similar to Java or C#. Because of that, most software engineers has no problem learning that. For the UI building, Flutter sees everything as widgets. This gives you full control over how your app looks and behaves. But initially, it may feel a bit verbose. Like React Native, Flutter also provides the developers with hot reload, which makes it easier to build an app. But unlike React Native's hot reload feature, it's more stable and faster and rarely breaks. So if you're already familiar with JavaScript and React, React Native may feel more convenient for you, but if you're just starting fresh, Flutter offers more tooling and features with better performance. As to the job opportunities, React Native continues to dominate the job market. For example, LinkedIn in the US lists more than 6,000 React Native jobs compared to 1,068 Flutter jobs. However, Flutter is growing fast. Job listings saw a 47% increase year over year. This is also related to the region. For example, there are more React Native jobs in North America and Europe, but Flutter is on the rise in Asia and Middle East. So, which one should you learn in 2025? If you're looking for more job opportunities right now, especially in North America or Europe, React Native might be the safer bet. Its JavaScript foundation, large community, and existing demand make it a practical choice, especially if you're already a web developer. But if you're starting fresh or you want better performance, more consistent tooling, and you're open to learning Dart, Flutter is catching up fast. Its job market is growing rapidly, and many developers find the experience cleaner and more enjoyable. At the end of the day, both frameworks are powerful. The right choice depends on where you are, what you already know, and where you want to go as a developer. If this helped you make a decision, let me know in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe if you want more real developer-focused content like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.